Where are we? What the hell is going on? The dust has only just begun to fall. Crop circles in the carpet, sinking. Spin me round again and rub my eyes. This can't be happening when busy streets amiss with people will stop to hold their heads heavy.
Guys, we want to tell you about this out of California. Of course, they're under a budget crisis. It is also hitting the state's child welfare services, too. But one woman is offering former foster kids a place to call home.
So where do they go when they have no place to go?
Unfortunately, this is it right here.
On the street.
They're living on the street.
18 is the end and safe home that they've been living in, which is their foster home. They need to leave that home. They are never told you're going to be out on your 18th birthday.
When they turn 18, they age out of the system. Studies show that 65% of them end up with nowhere to live, and nearly 40% end up homeless within 18 months.
But it's a surprise to the kids. And I truly believe most Americans don't know that foster care ends at 18. They're dropped out.
Seems like you have a lot of hurt inside.
Yeah.
Carla worries about her future. A common fear for kids who are released from California's foster care system at 18. But Lori Burns is trying to change their lives through the Teen Project.
Now a house in Lake Forest serves as a safe haven to help young women bridge the gap between a broken past and a bright future.
Turned her life around, and now she's making sure kids like Carla by providing them a place to stay.
The Teen Project is like a parent to the parentless, I call it, because we're giving kids what they should have had in the first place, a place to live.
The Teen Project also helps with mentoring and college scholarships for young adults.
Yes, a pillow and blankets and kitchen and bathroom and all the things that make a house a home. In this case, a haven for kids with nowhere to go.
Yeah, I don't have to worry about where I'm going to sleep. I could just come home, do my homework, go to school.
Not only is it beautiful, but my first reaction was like, I'm safe. Nobody can hurt me here, and I can just study and just be me.
And now, like, this house is like the physical evidence of like how amazing she is and how amazing like her whole dream is. And I'm just really lucky to be a part of it.
With the Teen Project through most of the construction, and just to see it from what it was before and how it is now, it's just like, it's amazing. They like, everything is just, it's so humble and just, it's just perfect. And to see all these people that, you know, they don't even know us and they're giving their money or their time, they're just like, love to us. And it feels really good. She gave me a house key, and I remember being so excited because I had never had a house key before.
What's great about this project is that I have an 18-year-old daughter, and she just graduated from high school a year ago, and she's away at college this year. Getting involved in this program opens your eyes to your kids or your children. Once they're out of the home at 18, can they really, excuse me, this is choking me up. Can they really survive and live on their own without the sustenance of a family environment?
Thanks to Homemade Orange County and many generous folks, the Teen Project offers not only shelter, complete with house mother, but career guidance, education, and access to health care.
You see the walls coming up in the frame. It's like, wow, you know, people care. I'm going to have a home. I'm gonna have dreams.
I think it's good.
going to cost around $215,000 to build it. We've got $100,000. But the team says, what are we going to do? And it's like, you know what? Faith. If 1,000 people gave $100, we'd be done with the house. Most of the parents of the kids were kids in the system that never got help. So how long can this go on? It's just going to keep on going and going and going until someone takes notice and says this has to stop. When I could take a child that's in pain and grab their hand and let them know it's going to be okay, they're going to have a life. That I am so grateful for every ounce of pain I ever went through in my entire life, because it's absolute gold when you could use it to heal someone else.